Thank you for calling. Please continue to hold for the next available agent.
Thank you for calling online support. This is Rose. How may I assist you?
Yes, it says my computer has been locked up and to call this number.
All right, sir, not to worry. I will help you. So can you please read what exactly the error message you see on the computer screen?
It says, do not restart your computer.
Mm-hmm.
Windows detected Zeus virus.
Zeus virus, okay. And is there an error code you also see?
Yes, B2957E.
All right, B2957E, like an Edwards, right?
Yes.
Let me check that error code for you, sir. Allow me a moment. And is this your personal computer or a business computer, sir?
This is my personal computer.
All right. And also, can you please tell me what exactly you were doing on your computer that time you got this message?
I was just browsing online, and I clicked a link, and I got this error.
Okay. So are you getting a blue screen error right now, a blue color screen?
Yes.
All right. So let me tell you the error code which you have just provided to me, as I've checked that in our system, and it says it's a blue screen error, and it generally comes whenever, like when we go to some unsecured website, such as a pornographic website, sir.
Okay. So,
right, so I believe you were on some pornographic website, right?
Yes.
And that is why you got that security alert, sir. But not to worry, we'll definitely help you for the same, sir. So, may I know what is the brand name of the device which you're using, sir? Which computer is this?
I think it's a Dell.
All right, Dell. Okay. Thank you so much for all these information, sir. As of now, what I understood, you are using a Dell, like a window computer.
And on
that, you got this error, and now you want to fix it. Am I correct?
Yes.
Surely, I'll assist you, sir, as we are here to help you. So this call is being recorded for quality and training purposes. And in order to fix that, I have to first find the root cause of that error. And for that, I need to connect your system to our secure server.
Okay.
So is it a laptop or a desktop?
It is a desktop.
All right, sir. I will guide you some steps which you need to follow. So can you please have a look on the keyboard at the very left bottom corner? There will be a window key which looks like a flat key.
Yes.
So you need to press and hold that Windows key and at the same time hit letter R as in Romeo. So Windows R all together. Do
okay.
That. And you will see on the screen a small box which will say type the name of the program.
Yes, I see that.
Wonderful. So now in that box, you need to type in H as in hotel.
Okay.
Another H as in hotel.
Okay.
Space, number one.
Number one, all right.
And hit okay.
All right.
And now you will get another option on the screen, another box, which will say HTML help box, this page cannot be displayed. Do you see that?
Yes.
Right, so on that box, if you can have a look at the very top left corner, there will be a small yellow colored question mark.
Uh-huh.
Click on that.
Okay.
Now you will see there will be some options below. So there will be one option which is jump to URL. Click on that.
Okay.
Jump. Yeah. Now below that you will see there will be an empty box there.
Uh-huh.
In that, you need to type in www.
Okay.
C as in Charlie.
Okay.
B as in Bravo, like a boy.
Okay.
T as in Tango.
Okay.
Another T as in Tango.
All right.
R as in Romeo.
Okay.
Dot com and hit OK.
Okay.
And hit OK and you will see establish support connection.
Yes.
Right. In that, type your first name and I will provide you the support key.
Okay. Just a second.
Okay.
You have to press another key, that is letter R. R as in Romeo. All right. So, are you getting a small window in the left corner of your screen? Type in the name of the program or show, right? All right. So, in that very box, you have to type in the name of program. I will let you know. So
you typed your name?
Almost. Sorry, I'm a slow typer.
No problem. You only have to type your first name, not your complete.
Oh, okay.
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 So now the support key is 160.
160.
208. 208. 639. 639. Yeah, and hit continue.
Okay. Okay, a thing just popped up.
Right.
Should I click run?
What all option do you see first of all?
I see run, save, and cancel. It's asking me about
click
a file
on run.
Download. Okay.
Yep, click on run. Now you will get another option. What do you see now?
It says that it's connecting. Go to assist is connecting.
Okay. All right, please wait.
Okay, it says Techies 22
yes,
S.
Click on
click
yes.
Yes. Okay.
Yeah, that's me. So thank you so much. Now, do you see the cursor is moving over the screen, sir?
Yes.
All right, that's me. Now your computer has been connected to our secure server, so I really appreciate your patience and efforts while taking a remote session. Now you can sit back, relax, and let me check what's wrong on this computer.
Okay, a box just popped up about sending an error.
All right, so your name is Mitch?
Yes.
Okay, let me just check that for you. So this computer, so this is the error?
Excuse me?
This is the error which you got. This is the error screen?
Yes.
All right, let me check that for you. So this is the only computer which is connected, or you have any other computer also which is connected to the same Wi-Fi?
This is the only one.
Do you have any printer or... Yeah, do you have any printer also?
No.
Don't have printer. All right. Let me check a few things on the computer. Allow me a moment.
Okay.
So you don't have any kind of security I can see here?
I have Komodo.
Komodo? What that is? Let me check that. Oh, that is for the internet security. You see that?
Yes.
That is not for the protection, sir. That will be only for the internet.
Oh, okay.
Right. And the kind of error message which you got in the computer screen, it is all because of the network infection, sir.
Oh, okay.
Okay. Right now, your network has been infected, and that is why you got this kind of security alert on the computer screen.
Okay.
So let me check a few things on the computer. Allow me a moment.
All right.
And may I know when was the last time you get this computer serviced by any certified technician?
Well, my son fixed it a few weeks ago. He's certified by Microsoft, but he's out of town right now, so I can't get him to help me with this.
Okay, right now you are also talking to the certified technician from Microsoft, sir, okay?
Oh, okay.
All right. So now I can see you are using the operating system, which is Microsoft XP Professional. Do you see that?
Yes.
And you bought this computer on 1st of December 2006, so it's pretty old computer, right?
Yes.
Okay. So it's almost like a 10-year-old computer, I would say. Now let me check the hard drive of this computer, the system drivers. System drivers are the brains of the computer. Okay.
Okay.
So if they are not installed properly, so it may even lead to the hard drive failure or a hard drive crash. So let me check the status of it.
Okay.
Do you see that state written here?
Do I see what?
You see the state written where I'm pointing the cursor here?
Oh, yes.
So these are all different status for the system drivers. You can see that.
Uh-huh.
Most of the drivers I can see stopped also. Did you see that?
Yes.
So first of all, out of all these drivers, we need to reinstall 60 to 70% system drivers out of all these drivers, okay?
Oh, okay.
Right. And let me just... So first of all, out of all these drivers, we need to reinstall that, okay?
Okay.
Now I'm just going to check some of the Microsoft services on this computer.
Okay.
Do you see that? These are all Microsoft services in your computer. And I can see some of the services are also stopped here.
Oh, yes.
Right. So did you stop them?
No, I did not.
Okay. It says Komodo is stopped showing here, and one Komodo is running here. Do you see that?
Yes. So how do we fix this?
So we need to reinstall all these services, first of all, and because they are all important services for the Microsoft and for your computer, sir. And I can see here the network firewall has been compromised here. Network firewall will basically protect the network from all kind of infection, from all kind of Trojan horse. But right now that service is showing stopped here. That is why this kind of infections are there on your computer screen, sir.
Okay.
Right?
Yes.
So let me check some of the system files, and for that I will recommend you to subscribe for the network firewall. Okay.
Okay.
Which will protect your network from all kind of infections, and so that you will not face this problem again in future.
Okay.
Right. You see that? 1,705.
Oh,
you
wow.
See the numbers?
That's a lot.
These are all, right, these are all errors and warnings, and they are all infections in your computer. And they are all with different date and timing. Let me scroll it down to check more on it, sir. I believe you're not aware of this, right?
No, I'm not.
And that is why it has been stored in your computer from long period of time. And today it's not like it has locked up your computer.
Okay.
Just because it has already been reached to that highest level, 1,705, right?
Yes.
So it has been, you can see, 22nd of November 2016. And it, in just 1 month, they are all of 1 month only, November, this month is November, and in just 1 month, you can see it has reached to 1,000 errors and warnings and infections, right?
Oh, yeah.
Right, so this has already been reached to the highest level, and that is why today you're not able to use your computer. It has blocked up your computer, sir. So we need to remove all the infections, all the warnings and errors from, not only from this computer, but also from your network, so that this will not again happen in your computer in future, okay?
Okay, so how do we do that?
So we'll be doing that for you. First of all, I'm just checking what the root cause of that, okay? So you don't have a printer?
No.
This is the only computer. You don't have any other tablet, laptop, iPad, right?
No.
All right. So do you see that active connections written here?
Yes.
So these are all active connections showing on your network right now, apart from this computer.
Okay.
According to you, just this computer is hooked up. But right now, as I have checked that, these are all different users, right? They are all using your network. And this is your IP address.
Well, I don't have a password on my Wi-Fi because I can never remember it. Do you think people might have gotten on my Wi-Fi?
Sir, that is why you can see that. Do you see that different addresses here at the right-hand side of it?
Uh-huh.
So they are all connected to your network. You can see that is the status here. It's established, established, established. Right? So these people are, like, they are all got established to your network right now. So it seems they have tracked, like, they might have tracked your IP address, and that is why they got established to your network. So definitely these people are accessing your network, sir.
Okay, how do I get them off of my network?
For that, we need to put security on the IP address so that no one can get into your network without your permission.
Right? Okay.
And also, we need to remove all unauthorized users from your network. And we need to delete all establishments to your network.
Okay.
So that it will be all safe and secure. Are you also doing any kind of banking stuff online for paying bills or for shopping, sir?
No, I go to the bank to do all my banking, and for my power bill, I go and to the office to pay that every month.
All right, and are you using any kind of email ID online? Like, you must be using your Gmail account, sir, I believe.
No, I don't have an email address.
Okay, and do you have any Facebook account?
No.
Or any social media account?
My son tried to get me on Facebook. I told him I didn't want to.
All right. So let me tell you, these people can steal any of your information. That is why. So we need to put security on that. All right?
Okay.
So let me tell you, sir, as we have checked basic things in your computer, what we found is the problem is not in this computer. The problem is only in the network. Your network got infected, and that is why it's all happening in your computer, sir.
Okay.
All right? So for that, I will recommend you to go for some network firewall security. Okay?
Okay.
Right. Let me just open up a notepad for you, sir. Do you see that notepad?
Yes.
So I will first of all write some action plan which really needs to be taken care in order to fix that computer for you. Are you able to read that?
Yes.
Okay. First of all, we need to optimize the overall performance of your computer.
Okay.
It will help your computer to run 3 times faster than the current speed of your computer. Second important thing that we need to put a security on your IP address, as we just checked that.
Okay.
So that no one can misuse or no one can use your network space. Okay.
Okay.
So once we put security on your IP address, it will just look like that. You see that? A bunch of stars only.
Okay.
So that will be the best security so that no one can get into your network and you can only use your network. All right?
Okay.
Then you don't have any kind of network firewall security and your network firewall security has been compromised. So we need to install the network firewall. It will protect your network from all kind of infections and viruses and unauthorized users and bad network sectors also, okay? Then as we check, the system drivers are stopped almost. So we need to make them running. We need to reinstall the system drivers. Okay?
Okay.
Then we need to remove all the warnings and errors and infections. Okay?
Okay.
Then we need to reinstall some of the softwares as they got in stock. And after doing that all, we need to remove the blue screen error which you got on the screen, sir. Okay?
Okay.
So these are the basic things, basic steps which we need to perform in order to fix that computer for you. Because the right now, the kind of error message you've got on the computer screen, it's all a one-stop error, which doesn't bring down the whole system if it not get deleted as quickly as possible, sir.
Okay.
Okay? For that, I will recommend you some of the security options. And if I'll ask you from your side, what do you think, for how long you would like to secure your network? May I know that? For a lifetime, for 7 years, or for 5 years maybe?
I'm probably going to be getting a new computer soon, so I don't want to do it for too long.
Okay. Right. In that case, we do have a better option for you. Because what all securities we are providing to you, they are all transferable. So even if you in future you are planning to buy a new computer, right? So that will again covered under the same security. You don't have to purchase any new security for your new computer or for new devices. So.
Okay.
Okay, that is the best part of the security. So basically we have three securities. I will write all in front of you. Okay?
Okay.
Then we have a 7 years.
First of all, it's optimization. You have to go ahead and optimize your computer and your network. And then we have to go there and do the inspection. Okay. So from the network, all right?
So let me tell you, the lifetime network firewall security will cover all of your present devices plus all of your future devices. In future, whatever devices you will be purchasing, right, that all will cover under the same lifetime security, right? And moreover, even in future, if you are planning to shift to new house, again, that will cover under the lifetime security, okay?
Okay.
And right, if you have any smart telephone, smart television, right, your printer, so that will also cover it under the lifetime security. Okay.
Okay.
And 7 years and the 5 years security, like 7 years and the 5 years network cover security will cover all the present devices only. Okay.
Okay.
So along with that, we'll also be providing to you a unique customer ID for your future reference, so that whenever you face any problem again in future, not only on this computer or on any of your devices, so you only have to dial our direct helpline number, okay?
Okay.
Right, and we'll be happy to assist you. And we'll also send each and every document in your email that will be sent to you from my billing department, okay?
Okay.
And we'll be providing you a customer ID so that whenever you are calling, you need to show your customer ID, confirm that, so that we can pull up the records with the help of your customer ID and we'll assist you for free. All right?
Okay.
Right. So let me just go ahead and type in the charges here also.
Okay.
That will be for complete 5 year security.
Okay.
That will be for complete 7 years. And that will be for complete lifetime. It will be covering your present as well as future devices.
Now, do I need a firewall?
Right, so because everything is, the problem is in the network, and your firewall has been, the network security, the network firewall has been compromised here. That is why you got that security alert.
Okay, so the firewall will keep people from seeing what I do online.
Right, sir, because as we check the status of that IP address, the internet protocol, people got established to your network just because you don't have any kind of security on the IP address.
Okay, now is your firewall also able to keep the FBI out of my network?
Right, sir.
Okay, it can keep the FBI out?
Right, and you don't have to, write down the password for it. As you were telling me that you don't remember the password, so it's not possible to remember that. That is why you haven't put the security or password on your IP address, right? But once we'll put security on that, we'll encrypt your IP address so that instead of looking that in digits, it will just look like a bunch of stars only. So
okay.
That no one can read that and, right, no one can get into your network. And the warnings and errors, we just checked that, right? That was all the activities which have been performed by those unauthorized users only who have been established to your network. That is the result of the error, sir.
Okay.
That is why your computer has been infected, right? So that is why the lifetime will cover all of your present plus future devices. Right, sir? And after that, I will assigning this case to my level 5 network engineer technician who
okay.
will work on this computer, who will fix that, and who will install all kind of securities on that. So you don't have to stay online till the time my technician will be working.
Okay.
Once he will fix everything, he will call you and he will inform you that now you can use your computer. Right, everything is working fine. So
okay.
he will at least take 35 to 40 minutes to fix that all for you, sir.
Okay, but I can still use it while he's doing that.
Right, you can watch what he is doing, what my technician is working on the computer. You can watch that at the same time.
Okay.
Right. So you can tell me, sir, which security you would like to go for, the lifetime, the 7, or the 5 years?
Well, probably the lifetime. That seems like a pretty good deal.
Definitely, sir, because it will be covering all of your present and as well the future devices, okay?
Okay.
So in case in future also if you're buying any other device like tablet, iPad, Kindle, Xbox, your printer also, so that will all covered under that, sir, okay?
Okay.
So let me first save this information on your desktop, okay?
Okay.
I'm saving it in the name of Micro Tech Support, okay?
Okay.
So let me just assign this case to my technician also so that he will start working on the computer.
Okay.
And just allow me a moment. So you'll be going for the slide time. Let me generate a customer ID for you also.
Okay.
So now let me just open up a link for you so that we can do that, right?
Okay.
Just allow me a moment, sir.
If you offer the 5-year plan, you will be automatically upgraded.
Do you have any Internet Explorer also?
I believe I do.
All right, I will check that for you also. And today it's on discount, sir, so it's all included, including all taxes, and you don't have to pay any technician charges, right?
Okay.
Right, so that will be free for you, sir.
All right, what I'll be providing you is, I'll be providing you 3 year technical support.
As it is running slow just because of that infection, I believe, so that is why it's taking time. So please be with me.
Okay.
So it's you only who using this computer or somebody else is also using, sir?
It's only me.
It's only you. Okay. So just allow me a moment. So just go ahead and fill that form by yourself. It's a secure payment form.
Okay. Now,
if you need any help, you can let me. Yeah, go ahead.
Do I have to put an email address in?
If you don't have any email, that's okay.
Okay.
Right. If you do have an email, so that we can send you each and every document on your email, so that will be great too.
Okay.
Yeah. So go ahead and fill that.
Okay. Let's see.
Yeah, if you need any help of mine, you can go ask me also.
That is why I'm trying to, you know, get you each and everything, benefits as well, the job card as well. Because I do know that you're spending this much of money, you know, one go. What we do, you know, spending this much of money. Now, can, you know, secure your future, right? Because if you don't go ahead and, you know, get this trip, you might have to bring a lot of money problems in the future. Regarding your own personal information, your personal security, and your computer security as well as your personal data as well. Because we have checked each and everything, and these things are, you know, required to be done right away.
Okay, now just click secure checkout now.
So you don't have any email ID, sir?
No.
For temporary basis, you can type in here na@gmail.com. Let me just type it for you.
Okay.
Annie@gmail.com. Now click on secure. Do you have any middle initial name also after your first name?
No.
No. All right. No problem. So is it a Visa or the MasterCard? Which one?
It is. I have a Discover card.
So we do not accept the Discover card.
Okay, well,
if you have any Visa or Master, you can do that.
Okay, I think I have a MasterCard. Let me look.
Okay, sir.
Oh, yes, I do.
All right, that's great, too. So you can click on Master.
click on natural touch.
Oh, okay, thank you.
All right, no problem.
Okay.
Please check all the details also.
Okay.
Now please check your card number again.
Okay, let me look over it again.
Please look at the card number.
Okay, that
it
looks like it's right.
It should be 16-digit number. So I just need your verbal authorization also, okay? So Mitch, do you authorize us to charge your MasterCard ending with 3344 for the amount of $799.99 for a complete lifetime security?
Yes.
Okay, so you checked your card number also?
Yes.
All right, click on yes. I mean, continue.
Okay.
Yeah. You clicked on that?
Yes.
The card number is invalid, it says. All right, let me check that. So it might be the card number is not correct.
Okay.
Let me check that. Check the card number, sir.
You don't think the FBI canceled this card, do you? They've been after me for a while now.
No, it says the card number is not valid. That's why it's not going through, sir.
Oh, okay.
Right. So let me just delete that, or you're right. We need to refresh the page also. Right, just a minute, sir. We need to refresh the page also, okay?
Okay.
Yeah. Just a minute, sir. We need to refresh that. Do not fill that again. Let me just refresh it.
Okay.
Just a minute. Oh, that payment link. We need to open that link again, I believe, right?
I think.
All right. Just a minute, sorry. Let me open this again, okay?
Okay.
Yeah. And which bank card is this, Nano? Like a Chase Bank or a Wells Fargo?
This is Chase.
Chase Bank, okay. You can see the system is running very slow. It's taking much time. All right, let me just open it for you.
Oh, I just got a pop-up that says network cable is unplugged. Where do I find that?
Oh, okay. The network cable, sir?
Yes.
All right, so please insert the cable again. The internet, you mean to say internet?
What?
Right. It says connectivity issues there, right? So I believe your internet is working slow.
Okay.
Right. So can you please check your internet, sir?
Okay. Let me check.
Yeah, I'll check your internet.
Okay, the first light on the internet box with the antennas, the first light is solid, the second one is blinking a little bit, the next three are off, the other one is blinking a little bit, and then the other two, the last two, are on solid. What does that mean?
All right, so do you see a cable wire behind that?
Yes.
It's a router or the modem. All right, so just re-plug the cable.
Okay. All right.
Yeah.
Now all the lights are off. Wait, wait, the first one on the left just came on.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay, the little pop-up just went away on my computer.
Okay. All right, it's working, I believe. All right, it's working. Just a minute. Now, let me just open it for you, sir. I think it's working now. You did something, sir?
No, I didn't do anything.
All right, that means now it's working. So, let me just refresh it. All right, so enter the mobile number, sir.
Okay. Oh, what just happened?
All right, just a minute, let me check that, sir. Stop moving your mouse, sir.
Okay.
Sir, do not use your mouse. Let me check that for you, okay?
Okay.
Yeah. Let me do it for you, sir. Now, just type in your mobile number, sir.
Oh, I can't read any of the stuff anymore. But what
you
what
can't
is
read
the,
that?
No, it's all blurry.
Yeah, it's all blurry, right? You might have clicked on something else, sir. But now you can see that.
Okay, I think so. Yeah. Okay,
yeah.
That looks right.
Right now, so you can fill that out. So do you see the numbers? I will just type it for you, sir, okay?
Okay.
Let me just type it, the numbers here. All right. Please wait.
Okay.
May I know who is your internet provider, sir?
The Comcast.
Comcast, all right. It's running very slow, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah. But not to worry, we'll increase the speed of your computer also 3 times faster than the current speed of your computer, sir, okay?
Okay, will that also make my internet faster?
Right, sir. And just a minute, just allow me a moment, sir. Let me just do it for you.
Okay.
Right, sir.
It was not authorized for an off-queue transaction. Are you there?
Well, I'm here, and I'm just fixing the computer, first of all, just allow me a minute.
Okay.
You can see that it's right. Have you clicked on the magnifying glass from your side, sir?
No.
No, okay. All right, let me do it from my side, sir, okay?
Okay.
And I need to transfer this case to my technician, as that infection is getting increased, it seems, right? You can see that in front of your eyes, sir.
Okay.
Right. Hold on, just allow me a moment, sir. Let me check that. Please be with me.
All right.
I'm trying to check that.
Oh, the little bubble popped up that said cable's unplugged again.
Oh, cable unplugged again. Please insert the cable.
Oh, never mind. It just went away.
Okay. So right now your internet connection is not working. All right, just a moment. It's fluctuating, right?
I think so.
Yeah, not to worry, so we'll fix that for you.
Oh, a notepad. Do I want to change the settings?
Sir, actually, I can see a very large screen right now, and that is the problem here, actually. I'm trying to minimize it, okay?
Okay.
Yeah. If you did something from your side, can you please resetting?
Reset my computer?
No, not reset your computer. Please check your internet again, sir.
Internet looks like it's working. Yeah, the internet's working. I was able to go to Yahoo.
All right. Okay. So not to worry, let me do one thing, sir. I will just take the details and I will just forward it to my billing department so that we can do the payment and my technician will start working on this computer, okay?
Okay.
Right. So your complete name is Mitch Cooper, right?
Yes.
And may I know the billing address?
345 East Street, Atlanta, Georgia.
Edwana? Edwana, you said?
Yes, Atlanta.
How do you spell it?
A-T-L-A-N-T-A.
I'm sorry, can you please pardon me one more time? A-C?
A-T as in Timothy. L as mm-hmm. in lemon. A mm-hmm. as in apple.
Oh, N, Atlanta.
Yes.
Oh, Atlanta, Georgia, right? I
yes.
got it. And the postal code will be?
98744.
98744. Okay, and just a minute. So it will be a MasterCard, right?
Yes.
Okay. And the card number will be?
Let me look at it. Let me get it under the light here so I can see it good.
Okay.
Okay, we've got 5465282393344.
All right, let me check that.
And it expires in December of this year.
All right, so it's December?
Yes, of this 16. Year. Yes.
All right, so 12/16, right?
Yes.
And the last three-digit number on the back of your card?
172.
172. So let me just correct, check all the information, sir. So your name is Mitch Hooper, and the number is 808-631-7275. And the billing address is 345 East Street, Atlanta, Georgia.
Yes.
Right. And the postal code is 98744.
Yes.
And that will be a MasterCard, expiration 12/16, and CVV is 172, correct?
Yes.
All right. So let me just transfer this to my billing department. Okay?
Okay.
And, yeah, just allow me a moment. Let me check. So also I need your work. Okay, you already authorized us to charge from your MasterCard, right, ending with 3344 for the amount of $799.99, right?
Yes.
All right. So just allow me a moment. I have already forwarded this to my billing department. And let me just connect this session to my technician also.
Okay.
Just give me a moment. Allow me a moment, sir.
Okay.
Let me check with my technicians, okay?
All right.
Right. Please be with me, sir.
Okay. Oh, my computer just turned off.
Oh, please turn it on, sir.
Okay.
Yeah.
Have to wait for it to finish turning off first.
All right, sir.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, it's starting up.
All right.
Okay, I'm on.
Okay. And if you get any option on the screen, please let me know also, okay?
Okay, it says go to assist connecting.
All right. Thank you, sir. I got that. So my technicians are already working on your computer, sir, okay?
Okay.
Right. So you're facing this problem for the very first time, sir?
Yes.
Okay. So please be with me, sir, okay? If
okay.
you want, you can put me on speaker also, and you can do your work, because my technicians are also working.
Oh,
all
it
right?
says updates are ready for my computer. I'm going to install them.
No, no, my technicians are doing that, sir. Do not touch your mouse, sir.
Okay, well, I'm already installing them.
Sir, but let me, sir, what are you installing right now? The update, sir. So they are all full of infections right now. It may increase infections.
It's installing a security update for Microsoft.NET Framework 4.
Okay. All right. But right now, I just want you to not touch your computer right now, okay?
Okay.
Right. So that update is not getting installed, sir. Do you see that?
It already installed the first one. Now it's on 2 of 13.
It will take some time because right now the infections are there, so we are removing that infection also.
Okay.
Right, so please leave with me.
Okay.
Yeah.
Should I click end now?
Sir, just wait.
Okay.
If it is get done, yeah, end now, yeah.
Oh,
so again,
the computer's turning off again.
So may I know why it's all happening again and again, sir?
I don't know. This started about a week ago. It just turns off by itself sometimes.
Oh, okay.
Hold on, I'm turning it back
on. Just turn it on. All right, so, and in the meanwhile, can I just check with my billing team and the technician also, sir?
Okay.
Yeah. So they are already working on that also.
Okay. Okay, the computer's back on now.
Right now, are you there, sir?
Yes, I'm here.
All right. So, the expiration date which you have just provided for to me is 12/16, right?
Yes.
All right.
It expires next
month. So that is, okay, it's 2016 or 2017?
2016.
Okay. But it's not like the payment not go through, sir. And let me, sir, you told me that it's of Chase Bank, right?
Yes.
All right. It's a, all right. So if, first of all, just turn on your computer.
It's on.
All right. And if you get any option on the computer, please click okay, click yes to connect this again.
Okay.
Right. And if you can flip your card, there will be a helpline number starting with 1-800.
Okay. Well, I have another MasterCard that doesn't expire for a long time.
All right. Oh, tell me that then.
Okay.
Yeah.
It's a MasterCard. It's 5248 25.
Just a minute, sir.
Okay.
From starting. Tell me from starting.
Okay, 5248 2507 1495 0369, and that expires February 2025.
Just a minute. 2025.
Yes.
Is that?
Yes. Do you need the 20... three numbers?
Just a minute, sir. Expiration date and the year I'm not confirmed. Please, can you please provide that again?
0225.
All right. So it's 0225, correct?
Yes.
And the three-digit number?
457.
And the rest of the details are same. You have a same name on that card also, right?
Yes, yes.
All right. Let me just try this. Allow me a moment.
Okay.
All right, so my billing department is already doing that.
Okay.
Yeah. And you can see that we have removed the infections, like we have removed that virus,
yeah,
which was there in your computer, right?
Okay.
You can see that it is not there. And also we are cleaning up some of the infections also.
Okay.
Yeah. Salami woman.
I'm going to go downstairs and get dinner started if that's okay.
No problem. Sure.
Should I bring my phone with me?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
If you want to go ahead and contact out the manager, you want to go ahead and process the problem.
Are you there, sir?
Yes, I'm here.
It says the card number is invalid. The card number you provided, it's not correct, sir. Can you please check the card number again?
Okay, let me go back upstairs.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, I've got the card.
Yeah.
Okay, the number is 5248.
Yeah.
2507.
Yeah.
1495-0369.
But it says invalid card number. We entered that number only, and it says it's the invalid card number.
Oh, they might have canceled that card.
Oh. Any reason for that? So why they cancel?
Well, lately I've just been spending a lot of money on alcohol ever since my wife left.
Oh, okay, all right.
And I lost my job, so I haven't been able to pay my credit card bills.
Okay. All right. So in that case, if we call to bank, they can open that?
If I call the bank, they'll open the card back up?
Yeah.
Okay.
Will they open that or not?
I'm not sure.
Mm-hmm. All right, we will do one thing here, okay? We can connect your call to the bank, okay? And
okay.
You need to tell them that you are making online payment or online shopping, but the card got declined, so please approve the payment. So they will approve the payment for you, okay?
Okay.
And if you can have a look on the back of your card, there will be a helpline number starting with 1-800.
Okay.
Yeah. Please provide that number to me.
It's 1-855-4-WALLET. And then...
I'm sorry, W?
A-L-L-E-T.
No,
and then it says says for outside the U.S. 1404-978-2954.
Okay, and you don't see any number starting with 1-800.
Well, it's 1-855.
Okay. Not to worry, we'll just try this number, second number which you have provided to me. So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to connect your call to the bank, okay?
Okay.
And you need to tell them that it's you who is, like, making this transaction. So you are making an online payment or online shopping, and the card got declined. So please approve the payment. So they will approve it for you, okay?
Okay.
So I'm going to connect your call. You need to follow the instructions here.
All right.
Thank you. Yeah.
No one is available at this time. Please leave a message after the tone.
Oh, it says no one is available on this number?
That's what I think it said. And then it said leave a message. Should I leave them a message and ask them to allow the payment?
No message. Or you don't have an email address, sir?
No.
You don't have an email address, right? Okay. And, okay, just a minute.
I can make one if you'll help me. I just don't know how to do it.
Sure.
Okay, let's do that.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
Okay, so how do I do that?
Mm-hmm.
All right, I'm back at my computer. How do I make an email address?
All right, but I was just asking, like, if you already have an email registered with your bank, then you might have received a message from the bank side.
Oh, no, I don't have an email address.
All right. And I believe the banks are closed this time, right?
Yeah, it's in the afternoon. They usually close around 5.
Okay, and let me check if you, like, if there is any toll-free number for 24/7.
All right, let me go get my card. Alright, are you there?
Yes, I'm here.
Okay. Oh, I see. I see what it says now. It says, 8554 wallet, but it also says, or call 8554 9255 3 8.
Okay, 8554 9255 3 8, correct?
1-855-4-9-2-5-5-3-8.
All right, let me just try this number.
Okay.
Right. You don't have to tell them that you are facing some computer problem and you're paying it online, right? You only have to tell them you are making online purchase for the amount of $799.99 and it got declined. So kindly approve the payment.
Okay.
Right? Let me just connect and check that.
Hi, thanks for calling Google. A specialist will be on shortly. And just so you're aware, your call may be monitored or recorded for quality and training, subject to our privacy policy.
Hi, thank you for contacting Google Support. My name is James. Can I have your first name, please?
Mitch.
Hello?
Can you hear me?
Nick?
Yes.
Yeah, I can hear you. Nick?
Yes.
How are you doing today, Nick?
I'm doing all right.
Okay. We'll change the bigger problem, and I'll do my very best, yeah.
I'm on the line with Microsoft Support, and I'm trying to buy... I got to pay $800 for them to fix my computer over the internet.
Mm-hmm.
And, this is the number on the back of the card I was trying to pay with. But they said the payment wouldn't go through.
Okay, Nick, you mean you're trying to make a payment for Microsoft?
Yes. Yes, to fix my computer for $799.
$799. Give me 1 second. Okay, Nick.
Okay. Yes.
I apologize for the inconvenience. but Nick. Okay. So I want to be honest with you because I'm not familiar with this, but I'm from wallet department, okay?
Okay.
So you're trying to make a payment to Microsoft. Is it from Play Store or?
No. I got an error code on my screen, and that gave me a number to call. And I called the number, and now they've connected to my computer and are trying to fix it. But they said it's going to cost $799.
Mm-hmm, I see. Okay. All right, so if that is the case, okay, I'll be providing Microsoft number. Okay, you have a pen and paper, Richard?
Yes, just a second. Okay. All right, I got a pen and paper.
Hello, are you there, sir?
Yes.
It seems the call got disconnected, sir.
Oh, okay.
All right, so I just let me just connect the call again.
Okay.
And just allow me a moment. Let me just check that, sir. Let me try to connect this number.
Okay.
Thank you for calling J.P. Morgan. This call will be monitored or recorded. Thank you for calling J.P. Morgan Chase. The switchboard is now closed. If you need to report a lost or stolen debit card or check, make a payment, transfer funds, or obtain other account information, please dial 1-800-935-9935.
All right, so that means the banks are closed this time, okay?
Okay.
Right, I just tried the number 24/7, but the banks are closed this time. And so this is the only card number which you have right now. You don't have any other cards, right?
I have some Discover cards.
No, Discover card, we cannot accept the Discover card.
Okay.
Okay. Let me just check that.
Okay.
I have just one more number. Let's check if this number gets connected or not.
Welcome to the Chase Internet Service Center. Para español, oprima asterisco. For automated account information, press 1. For personal online or mobile banking support, press 2. For business online or mobile banking support, press 3. To repeat these options, press 4. To speak with a customer service specialist, press 0. Before we connect you to a customer service specialist, please enter your debit card or account number, followed by the pound key, so our specialist will know who you are when they answer your call.
One moment while we connect you with a customer service.
This call will be monitored or recorded.
Welcome to Chase. My name is Rio. May I have your first and your last name, please?
Mitch Gopher.
Thank you. And how can I help you?
Yes, I had an account with you guys not too long ago. But you guys closed my account because I had around $20,000 and I haven't paid it back yet. But I'm having computer problems, and I need you to open up my account so I can pay Microsoft $799 to fix it. Is there, if I give you the account number, can you reopen the account so I can pay for it?
Well, let me just try to see what we can, because normally once an account has been closed, it cannot be reopened. So if you wish to open a new account, then you will need to step inside the branch or go online to open a new one.
Okay.
But let me just try to check what we can do, okay?
Will I have to pay that money back before you reopen the account?
Well, if you owe the bank some money and you wish to open a new account with us, then yes, you will have to pay for it first before a new account can be opened.
Okay, because I owe about $20,000, but I don't have any of that money.
Oh, I see. Then if that's the amount that you owe us, then you'll have to pay for it first.
Okay. Well, thank you.
You're most welcome. Any other questions or anything else I can help you with?
No, that's it.
All right, perfect. Thank you for calling, Chase. You have a good one.
You
Take
too.
Care. Bye.
All right, sir, are you there?
Yes.
So they have closed your account, right?
Yes.
The MasterCard account which you have provided me, which is ending with 369. So that account has been closed?
Yes.
All right, so you can provide me the other MasterCard number. Like, you can tell them you have other card number, right? So that you
that, those for those, that, those were all on the same account.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, all those cards were on
but
the same Chase
have,
account.
Okay, but you do have a payment. You do have an amount in that card, right?
I don't think it works anymore.
Mm-hmm. And one you said like the card got expired, maybe you don't know. So what about that, sir?
Oh, that card? Hold on.
So you can tell them like the card got expired. So you can talk to them. Can you pay from that card? So you can tell them. You can ask them.
Okay, sure. Yeah, if you call them back, I'll.
So let me. Sure, let me just connect your call again to them, okay?
Okay.
Yeah.
Welcome to the Chase Internet Service Center. Para español, oprima asterisco. For automated account information, press 1. For personal online or mobile banking support, press 2. For business online or mobile banking support, press 3. To repeat these options, press 4. To speak with a customer service specialist, press 0. Before we connect you to a customer service specialist, please enter your debit card or account number, followed by the pound key, so our specialist will know who you are when they answer your call. One moment while we connect you with a customer service specialist. This call will be monitored or recorded. You have been chosen to participate in a brief customer satisfaction survey. If you wish to participate, please stay on the line at the end of your call, and you will be connected to the survey. The customer service specialist will not be aware of your participation.
Welcome to Chase. My name is Jean. May I please have your name?
My name is Mitch Gopher.
Yes, hello, sir. How can I assist?
Yes, I'm trying to pay Microsoft to fix my computer, having some computer issues. They said it's going to cost $799. They're actually on the line with me. Anyway, they don't accept Discover Card, and I had an account with you guys. But, you guys closed the account when I was about $20,000 in debt and I hadn't paid it back yet. But I have one of my old cards. It's expired, but they wanted me to see if I could call you and you guys could pay for it with the expired card on the canceled account.
What type of account do you have with Chase? Is it a business account or a personal checking account?
Oh, it's a personal credit account.
Credit card, right? Credit
yeah.
Card account?
Yeah.
Okay, so sir, for that, okay, I apologize, but I won't be able to pull up credit card accounts. So kindly stay in the line if it's okay. I'll direct you to a specialist from the credit card team to help you out, okay?
Okay, thank you.
Stay in the line, please. I'll get you a specialist who can help. No problem, sir. Connecting.
Please enter the customer's 16-digit credit card number. Please enter the customer's 16-digit card number.
Transferring to a customer service specialist.
So stay online, Jordan.
This call will be monitored or recorded.
Thank you for calling Chase. My name is Marie. Can I please have the 16-digit number on the credit card you're calling about today?
Before I give you the number, I just have a question. Is it okay that the card's expired and I don't have an account? Like, you guys can still pay for Microsoft for me?
Not if the expiration has already expired. Not if the card has already expired.
Okay. Well, that's why Microsoft, is with me calling you guys, because they don't accept Discover Card, and I had an account with you guys, but you see, my wife left me and I started drinking and I lost my job, so I was just living off my credit card, and then next thing I knew, I was $20,000 in debt and I wasn't able to pay you back, and you guys canceled my account.
Okay, well, if you cancel the account, not supposed to go through either.
Okay.
Because we're not going to be able to. You have to apply for another credit card.
Okay. Now, can I apply even though I haven't paid back the money for my previous account?
Yeah, you should be able to apply.
Okay.
All right, do you have any other questions for me? Any concerns?
No, that's it. Thank you.
All right, well then I hope you got everything figured out. Thank you for calling Chase. Have a wonderful day.
You too.
Yeah, are you there, sir?
Yes, I'm here. They said they won't be able to, if the card's canceled and I don't have an account, they can't cover it.
Mm-hmm.
I have four Discover cards here if you want them.
So we do not accept the Discover card, right?
Okay. Well, I mean, that's what I use whenever I go to the store, and they don't have a problem with them.
Right, but we do not have any access to them, that, sir. If you have any Visa card, sir, like, if you don't have MasterCard, do you have any Visa card, any other card?
No, sorry. Oh, wait, I think I actually might have an old Visa card. Let me go check.
All right.
All right, let's see here. Oh, I do.
All right, you do have the Visa card.
Yes.
And that is valid, sir?
No, it expires in 2017. Yeah, it's good.
Oh, it's good to go? All right, so we can try that, sir. Okay, tell me that the card number.
Okay, it is 4913 7720 1018 5702.
And the expiration date?
0417.
All right. And the 3-digit number?
079.
All right. Let me just try to charge with this.
Okay.
Wait, just allow me a moment.
Okay.
So do you authorize us to charge from your Visa card ending with 5702 for the amount of $799.99?
Yes.
All right. Let me just try to make the payment, and let me check with my billing department, sir. Okay? Allow me a moment.
Okay.
Yeah. They are trying to make the payment.
Okay.
My billing team. Let's check if it will go through. It says, please contact bank. It's and which bank card is this, Manu?
I'm not sure. The number's on the back, though.
All right. Is it Chase Bank, Wells Fargo, or which bank?
I'm not sure. I found it outside.
Okay, no problem. So can you please flip the card and you will see the helpline number there.
Yes. 888-973-9083.
All right. So let me tell you, so this time you don't have to tell them the whole thing that you are paying this amount to Microsoft and all. You simply have to tell them that you're making an online purchase and the card got declined. All right? So kindly approve the payment.
Okay. All right.
Right. Let me just connect your call this time.
Care will be closed starting Wednesday, November 23rd, 2016 at 2 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. Thursday, November 24th, 2016 and Friday, November 25th, 2016 in observance of Thanksgiving. If you need immediate assistance with balance inquiries or reporting your card lost or stolen, please call our card services at 866-242-5198 for further assistance. Thank you and have a great day. Welcome to Whippet Customer Care. We are here to help you with your Sprint Money Express. To continue in English, press 1. Are you calling about your Sprint Wireless account? Press 1 to be transferred back to Sprint Wireless.
Just allow me one moment, sir.
Okay.
The business you called is still in operation, but can no longer be reached at this number.
Sir, allow me a moment.
Okay.
Sir, I just tried to check that, but I don't find which bank card number is this, all right? So you don't know which bank card is this, sir? Like the Chase, the Wells Fargo, or any of the local bank?
It says Whippet on the front. Is that a bank?
Which bank, sir?
It says Whippet on the front, W-I-P-I-T. I found it on the side of the road, and I thought, yeah, there might be some money in it.
Okay. All right. So, Whippet, it's W-I-P-I-T, right?
Yes.
Okay. And, all right. So, if it not go through today, so I will also call you tomorrow so that we can try to make that payment tomorrow, okay?
Okay.
And otherwise, my technicians are already working on your computer. You can see that, sir, and it's almost done. Okay?
Okay.
Yeah. And do you have any alternate number? If this number is not reachable, we can call you.
I don't know if you're going to be able to reach me tomorrow. My phone bills.
Oh, man,
my phone bills was due today, and none of the cards I tried to pay with would pay for it. So they're probably gonna turn off my phone tomorrow. But
okay, and you don't have any other number?
No.
This is the only number.
But you can try to call me again on this number.
Sure, we'll try to call on this number only tomorrow.
All right.
Okay. And is this a kind of prepaid Visa credit card, something like that?
I'm not sure. I just found it on the side of the road. I don't know whose it is.
Okay. And, in that case, sir, we need to call you tomorrow, and we can try that payment tomorrow, okay?
Okay. Do you think you could try to work on it to where you can charge my Discover card tomorrow?
So we don't accept the Discover card, okay?
Well, I mean, I know that one will work.
Yeah. Discover, we don't take Discover, right? And in that case, sir, we'll just try to call you tomorrow, and we'll just try to make the payment tomorrow, okay?
Okay. Now, you do know that the Windows XP that you were fixing was actually just a virtual machine, and I know you guys aren't really Microsoft.
So we are the certified technician for Microsoft, sir, okay?
That might have been what they told you, but you're really not.
Right, we are, the name of the company is Microtech Support, okay?
Yeah, that's not a subsidiary of Microsoft.
Right.
Anyway, have a nice day and stop scamming people, alright? Talk to you later.
I'm sorry?